boys and ghouls, to the Frankson Art Center on this creepy and kooky evening. So we ensure a mysterious and spooky show, please make sure all phones are turned off. Also make sure that all pagers and watch alarms are sent back to the 80s where they belong, or on silent. Please also leave any torture devices with your nearest usher, although we do strongly encourage their use after the show. Recording of this show is strictly prohibited. Don't make us get all ooky with you. Smoke, lighting, and special effects will be used through the show, as well as many creatures and creepy crawlies that we have no control over whatsoever. If you do find something lurking under your seat, please do not get them wet or feed them after midnight. So sit back, but don't relax too much. We're gonna pay a call on the Addams Family.
We shall remain as besotted with each other as the night we met. our first date. You took me to see
Death of a Salesman.
How we laughed.
When you're an Addams,
you gotta have a lot of passion.
When you're an Addams,
you need to really love your wife
at least twice a day.
You're happy when your toes are in the mud. You smile a bit the moment you smell blood.
Awoo!
When you're an Addams,
you've got to grab a bow and arrow.
Our beloved ancestors. Why do we do this?
Because living or dead, family is still family.
Yes, and how do we do this?
By dancing on their graves.
Yes, dance, my brother Fester, dance. Time to wake the dead. Ancestors, back to your crypt.
Hey, it's locked.
That's right. We have a problem.
Lady Addams, that irresistible little bundle of malice who would poison her own brother just for arriving in an ambulance, has grown up and found love.
Oh, Wednesday, I just want to lock you up in a little white cottage with a picket fence and an apple tree.
I like that part about being locked up.
So, here's the deal. Gather around. I'm not letting you back into that crypt until love triumphs. So, who is this Lucas fellow? Is he right for her? Do they love each other? What is love anyway? Does this rash look serious to you? It does. I'll get a second to pick. Where was I? Look, that's right. So many questions about love. But when you think about it, is there anything more important? Thank you, Thing. Let's not talk about anything else but love. Aww. Let's not talk about anything else but love. Can't we talk about lofty goals, mating souls, altering minds and faltering roles? Let's not talk about anything else.
Ha! Ah! Ooh, ah! Fight, sir! Fight! Fight like a man! Feel the kiss of my Spanish steel! Ha! Ah! Foiled! Again. Damn you and your lightning reflexes.
Gomez, look.
Flowers. Who would send something so tasteless?
The most precious gift there is, more goody-licious than gold, is that blessing we call friendship, whether new or very old.
Goody-licious? Who talks like these?
The Beinekes. Wednesday's friend Lucas and his parents, they're coming for dinner tonight.
Lucas?
Yes.
But Lucas is a boy's name.
Yes.
Wednesday has a friend who's a boy?
It's nothing, dear. Puppy love. Ugh. Put these in water.
Mom, Dad, I shot dinner.
Oh, Wednesday, that's lovely. Wherever did you find it?
Petting zoo.
Thank you, dear. Come, Lurch, we'll whip up something really special. And this time, we'll actually cook it. Ma! Oh, Gomez, guests for dinner. Fresh meat.
Daddy, Daddy, I have something very important to tell you.
What?
Can you keep a secret?
Of course.
Look.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say that looked like an engagement ring. What did you sing?
Oh, Daddy, Lucas wants to marry me.
What?
Lucas Beinecke loves me and he wants to marry me.
Do you want to marry him?
Yes, I think so.
You think so?
Well, I've never met his parents and he's never met mine and I just need to make sure.
That he's the one?
That the families can get along. He has to know what he's getting into.
What are you saying?
I'm saying we're who we are, and they're from Ohio.
Oh, Ohio, a swing state.
That's what I mean.
No, you are right. This is important. Let's go tell your mother.
No!
No? You don't want me to tell your mother?
Please, Daddy. She'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing.
You don't want to tell your mother you're getting married?
After dinner, when we're all friends, then we'll tell her.
But I've never kept
Daddy.
Anything from your mother
please,
before.
Please, Daddy.
But...
Do you love me, Daddy?
There are two things I would never do. Say no to my wife. Say no to my daughter. So what exactly should I do?
Do you realize what you're asking me to do?
Oh, please, Daddy. Just one tiny little secret. Just one, please.
No,
please!
all right, I promise I won't tell your mother.
Thank you, Daddy! our little secret, right?
Yes, yes, our little secret. Wednesday's growing up, but I'm not ready. Wednesday's growing up as time slips by. When did she become someone else's chum? Someone else to make her father wonder why, oh why? Wednesday's growing up. Should be Thursday before you know it. A puzzling thing. A secret in the house. A boy, a girl, a ring.
Something's wrong with Wednesday.
What do you mean?
She's in the kitchen. Smiling. Like this. Maybe it is this boy.
Ah, this boy, don't be silly. Ha, I say. And double ha, ha, ha. You yourself said, puppy love. Come, my darling. I feel the urge to take you in my arms. Let's go upstairs.
Gomez!
On the other hand, she is a healthy young woman, like you were. Are, like you are. She might even fall in love and get married, like you did.
Don't be ridiculous, Gomez. I'm far too young to have a married daughter.
Of course, I didn't think of that.
Besides, Wednesday will have lots of boys.
How do you know?
Because she's my daughter.
Yes, but what if, and I have no reason for saying this, what if she did find the one who stole her heart?
Don't be silly. When that happens, I'll be the first to know. Wednesday tells me everything. Just like you do.
There are three things I would never do. Lie to my wife, lie to my daughter, or tell the truth to either one.
Gomez, you do tell me everything, don't you?
Of course!
Oh my, you are perspiring.
What, what?
I do hope you're not coming down with a case of liar's shingles.
Liar's shingles?
I think Wednesday and I should have a little chat.
Like a bull in the ring, like the moderate right wing, I'm trapped. Like the moss on the stump, or the wig on Donald Trump, I'm trapped. With my wife to my left, and my daughter to my right, any thought of my escaping must be scrapped. I could choose, sing the blues, but no matter what I do, I'm trapped, trapped, trapped. Like a boat in a lock, or a cuckoo in a clock, I'm trapped. Like a corpse in the ground, or like theater in the round, I'm trapped. I could cry, I could lie, I could simply up and die, but I fear the dice I rolled are finally cracked. Should I beg, should I rage, or stay safely in my cage? Ha! Trapped, trapped, trapped. How can I keep a secret from the woman I adore? The bitter breeze that keeps me here and coming back for more. She stokes the Addams fire, she harbors each desire. I never tell her lies, but when my daughter cries, how can I be expected then to turn the other cheek? Should I not be her hero, stead of sniveling and weak? I'll pick the route that's true, tell me what I must do! Should I gripe, should I groan, would I rather pass a stone? Trapped. Wife gone wild, crazy child, little me unreconciled, I'm trapped. If I'm wrong, I'll be strong, and I'll try to get along. Or I'll fail, have to bail, show my coffin to the nail. If I napped, if I snapped, maybe dinner would be scrapped. Then I wouldn't be trapped. Ha! Trapped! Ha! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Ah! Pugsley. Ever since I met him, I want to laugh and cry, and everything seems right and wrong at the same time. And then sometimes, I just want to rip his flesh off and eat it up until there's nothing left. I don't have a sunny disposition. I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's locked in one position. See my face, I'm enthused. Suddenly, however, I've been puzzled. Bunny rabbits make me want to cry. Oh, my inhibitions have been muzzled. And I think I know why. I'm being pulled in a new direction. And I think I like it.
There will be no dinner.
Gomez, do you love your daughter? Do you care for her mental well-being?
Of course.
Do you want her to be put on heavy medication and spend the rest of her days hating us because we let her ruin her life?
There are four things,
Gomez,
I would never...
Will you stop that?
I think we should have this dinner.
Why?
Because we need to introduce her to the world.
Are you out of your mind? Have you seen the world lately? Now, stop prattling and go tell her the dinner is off.
But Kyle,
you're the father. The father is the counselor. And if after 25 years of marriage you can't do this one thing for me, then I just don't know what.
Okay, family meeting about tonight. Come on! What do you want?
I wonder what we're going to do.
Okay. First, we'll have drinks like, hi, see the house. And then at 8, we'll have dinner, and they'll be back at their hotel at 9:30.
Wednesday, your father has something to tell you.
Actually, Paloma, your mother and I, we've had second thoughts.
What about?
Look, this dinner, it all seems so quick.
It's not quick! Oh, please, Daddy! It's just a dinner, and they're dying to meet you. And I promised Lucas, and you know how I hate to break a promise.
Yes, Paloma, but your mother and I...
Daddy, I am your only daughter and your eldest child, and if you can't do this one thing for me, then I just don't know what!
Maybe just a little dinner.
Thank you, Daddy!
Well, it seems I've been outvoted. So, dinner it is. Drinks, dinner, and then the game.
Oh no! Not the game.
But it's a family tradition.
But it's my dinner!
But it's my house, darling. Drinks, dinner, and then the game.
One out of two, Paloma. Don't push it.
Then can we at least all act normal? Define normal!
Normal is an illusion, darling. What's normal for the spider is a calamity for the fly.
Mother, please! They're normal people, not like you, not like me. Please, can't we be an average family? One normal night, that's all I want, that's all I need from you. One normal house without a mouse to feed a plant or two. You must admit we're not what people call me back.
First saw her. I was lost in the park and a pigeon dropped at my feet with an arrow in it. I looked up and there she was, Wednesday, with a crossbow.
With a what?
A crossbow, you know.
She walks around Central Park with a crossbow?
It's okay, Dad. She has a permit.
Oh, good. Good choice, son. Now this is what's gonna happen. We're gonna head back to that hotel and then you and I, we are gonna have a little talk.
Don't be patient with him, dear. A father should support his son and Lucas is your only one.
Look what you went and did. Your mother's rhyming again. When we get back to that hotel, we are gonna sit down.
Not one normal night, no, not one poem, not one inspiring word. One normal scene, complete routine.
They're not right for each other.
What do you mean they're not right for each other? Was Napoleon right for Josephine? Was Nausea right for Dramamine? Were the 80s right for the drum machine? Who's to say? Who's to say? Was ballet right for Balanchine? Was polio right for the soap vaccine? Charlie Sheen. Who's to say? One of the night is a perilous trip. Normal is hard to attain. Children are crazy, parents are quick. Passions are hard to explain. But this is that moment, and this is your chance. So if you don't want to remain, stop singing a flaw.
What?
Flaw.
No.
Flaw. Only affairs of the heart.
Look, it's your choice. Either we help these kids, or you're stuck here for eternity. So,
we'll help them all.
Nice talking to you.
Get your hands off me.
Alice, it looks like we landed in Weird City. I say, quick drinks and bye-bye.
Oh, Mal. Be open to experience and welcome in the new. Reach deep in your surprise bag. There just might be a gift for you.
Honey, my surprise bag is so full, I can hardly lift it. You know the guy at the airport that patted me down? He slipped me his telephone number. I don't think I can handle any more surprises.
Come on, Dad, lighten up. These are your kind of people, real salt of the earth.
Oh, yeah? Where are they from?
Where are we from? Funny you
you should ask. July 31st, 1715, the Spanish warship Pico de Gallo, commanded by my great nautical ancestor, Captain General Rondano Ventano Don Jose Guerra Crevi, leaves Madrid, bound for a new land. 3 weeks later, he is still in Madrid, as Madrid is 400 miles from the nearest ocean. A stubborn man, he sets sail anyway, only to sink 6 months later off southern coast of Florida, a hostile land infested with mosquitoes, rattlesnakes, and many retired Jewish peoples. But enough about us. Mr. Malcolm Beinecke, I presume. Mwah, mwah. And you must be the lovely Mrs. Malcolm Beinecke. And you must be Lucas. Unless, of course, you are the father, and you are the son, with a massive thyroid problem. I go too far. No, madam, the night, she is young. Welcome to our extremely normal home. Gomez Florencia Addams at your service. And allow me to present my wife, Latiana, mother of my children, al amor de mi vida, love of my life, Morticia!
Sorry I'm late. I was putting the apple pie on the windowsill to cool.
That's my little woman. Oh, a duchess in the parlor and a genius in the kitchen.
Oh, Gomez.
And a gymnast in the bedroom.
So very pleased, Mr. Beinecke.
Mrs. Addams?
Yes. Mrs. Beinecke.
Oh, Alice.
Alice. And you must be Lucas.
What a lovely name.
Thanks. I'm named after my Uncle Lucas, who got lost in the woods, ate his own leg.
She doesn't need to know that, Lucas.
Oh, no, no. It's a beautiful story. Wednesday has a cousin who swallowed his own tongue. He hawked like this. Hello? How are you?
Thank you, Mother! Hi, I'm Wednesday.
What are you wearing?
A dress.
A yellow dress?
Oh, Paloma, what happened? You look like a crime scene.
Will you excuse us for a moment? I will not have that color in my house.
I'm just being normal, okay?
Darling, we don't wear bright colors. Bright colors are for people with no inner life and no imagination. Oh, God. Look, it's everywhere.
Oh, it's a beautiful dress, Wednesday. Oh. Yellow is the color of the warming sun. Yellow is the color of yumminess and fun. Why not show the world the love in which we all believe? Why not wear your heart for all to see right on your sleeve? Yellow is...
Excellent! A wonderful sentiment about the color.
Yellow!
And now, oh, why look! Oh, it's Pugsley Addams, Wednesday's little brother, just home from Bible study. Say hello, Puggles.
Hello! Want to make a donation?
Oh, of course, sweetheart. And what are you collecting for?
Just put some money in the can and nobody gets hurt! Phew! Oh, boy, is it normal out there?
Yes, this is our dear little grandma, the very soul and spirit of the family.
Hi, I just came from the hospital, the cardiac ward.
They're dropping like flies. I hope you're staying in shape. Grains, fresh fruit, 45 minutes on the treadmill.
Well, I know I should, but I don't do any of that.
Well, you're gonna die, honey.
Are you ready for some football? Faster's got the ball. He's running. He's dodging. Look at that some bitch go. Ah! He's on the 20. He's rounding third and...
is my brother, Fester.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you, Fester. All right, go away now.
Goodbye.
Have a nice dinner.
A welcoming toast from the extensive Addams Caves.
Children, you're excused.
Lucas, come on. Daddy, remember?
Not to worry, Paloma. I got this. Are you two leave the door open, you hear? Ah, you concerned they will make the beast, eh? Not to worry, my friend. My daughter has a black belt in Taekwondo. He tries anything, and she'll rip his throat out to the children.
Excuse me, but do you have a little girl's room?
Oh, we used to, but we let them all go.
Come with me, dear. I'll show you.
Yes, a grand tour for the missus. And the mister and I will go below for some guy stuff. Then dinner.
And after dinner, the game.
The game? What game?
Did you ever play charades?
Yeah.
Well, it's nothing like that.
Oh, Morticia, did you get the flowers I sent you?
Oh, yes. And the lovely poem. Wherever did you find it?
I wrote it?
No.
When I'm depressed or feeling blessed, a poem will get it off my chest. They come to me, they take no time and just pop out and always rhyme.
Maybe you should see someone about that.
And they're always about the one thing everyone needs, but so few have.
Healthcare.
Why, love, of course.
How silly of me.
Let's not talk about anything else but love. What's repeating? Let's not talk about anything else but love. Can't we talk about lofty goals?
Dating souls, faltering minds and faltering roles.
They're gonna freak when we tell them.
My father won't.
What? Why not?
I already told him.
What? You told your father? Your father with the sword? You told him we were getting married just like that?
He's totally cool with it. Mostly.
I thought we were gonna tell them all together.
We need his help. You don't know my mother. She could really screw this up.
I'm not marrying your mother.
I know. Look. It might seem old-fashioned, but I want their blessing.
You're right, it is old-fashioned.
Lucas, do you love me?
Of course.
Then leave it to me. It's all going according to plan.
Plan? What plan?
That's the plan. Improvise. Keep them guessing.
You're really crazy.
You say that like it's a bad thing. Come on, it's just a simple dinner. What could go wrong? Come on.
Be patient, and soon the way will be clear. Focus your fear, and troubles all will disappear. Let's bring it on home. Let's not talk about anything old.
Please don't leave us out in the cold.
Let's not talk about anything else but love.
But love.
But love!
Interesting chair. Antique?
Ah, 15th century, the heretic's chair. Once owned by Thomas de Torquemada, Grand Inquisitor of Madrid.
You collect his stuff.
Ah, a man must have his hobbies. Some play cards, some play golf. Me, I collect instruments of persuasion. Why, you may ask? Go on. Ask. Ask.
Why?
It's fun. The history of the world told in agony and dismemberment. Get up, I show you. Up, 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 up. So, you sit, they ask a question. You don't like the answer? Ooh! Ah, that'll make you believe, eh? Sit down, I ask you a question, okay?
Perhaps some other time.
Okie dokie. So, how about these crazy kids, eh?
I know, how about them?
Well, they seem very fond of each other, no?
Yeah. Not like they're getting married or anything.
Married? Of course not. They're way, way, way too young. Of course, they marry young these days, do they not?
I don't know what they do.
Then speak of you, the Beneke saga, that your hopes, your dreams, your son.
Lucas? Yeah. He's a little soft. He takes after his mother. I'll wait till he finishes school, then I'll teach him the family business and make him a man.
May I say something? You and I feel we understand each other. Do you feel this?
No. Tell me, Addams, 2,000 square feet in the middle of some central park? How do you manage to score this place?
But these 2 acres have been in my family ever since Queen Isabella of Spain deeded it to my ancestor, Alfonso the Enormous, for services rendered.
Services? What services?
Alfonso the Enormous. The Enormous? Do I need to draw you a diagram? Ah, come, Beinecke, I show you the moat. Quick, 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 up here. Oh, wait, did you bring a bathing suit?
No.
Oh, not to worry, let's be crazy.
And this is Cousin Helga from Baden-Baden.
Ooh, and who's that looking over her shoulder?
No, that's her other head.
She has 2 heads?
Well, you know what they say.
And who's that man in the dress?
That's Aunt Herman, Wednesday's uncle, twice removed.
I don't understand.
Well, they removed it once, but it grew back. And this is Gomez and me at our wedding.
Oh, what's that?
Our wedding vows.
Oh, that's so romantic. We promise to tango at least 3 times a week.
For passion.
We promise to tell each other everything.
For truth.
Everything?
Of course.
And you're still married?
More than ever.
Boy, sure doesn't work that way in our house.
Well, how does it work?
Well, what's good for the gander is a nice, quiet goose. If I told Mel my secrets, all hell would break loose.
Alice, I'm shocked. What sort of a marriage is it where you keep secrets?
A long one.
Secrets are the enemies of passion. Speaking true will get you through the day. Truth is not a thing that one should ration, but I think you think of it that way. Never keep a sin inside the closet. Always give the facts a fighting chance. Every time you do, it's a deposit in the long-term life of your romance.
By far.
a doubt.
And if he told you a lie, you whisper goodbye, then leave him to carry on.
That's it, exactly.
Is there no room for some discussion?
She kept a secret and they shot her with an M16.
That's not a pretty scene.
She kept a secret and she wound up on the cover of a magazine. She's quite the Philistine.
What's this one?
The dance routine.
Afford an engagement ring?
Well, after school, I work at the bookstore. Weekends, I tutor kids at a charter school. And summers, I work at my uncle's grocery store.
And is any of this true?
Most of it.
And in your time off, wise guy?
Mostly, I think about Wednesday and how much I love her and how we could have a wonderful life together.
And what does a Lucas Beinecke become when it grows up?
And maybe a writer?
Ooh.
Or a medical examiner.
Medical examiner? Why?
Because you get to look at the inside of people's bodies and they don't mind because they're dead. Where did you find him?
We found each other. It's kind of a miracle.
Gomez!
Oh my god, Daddy!
What are we gonna do?
No, let's just tell her. It's gonna be fine.
Daddy, you said after dinner.
No, okay. You go to Nelson. No, you. What are we gonna do?
What were the three of you whispering about?
The weather.
The economy.
The economy.
Okay, we're gonna go now. See you at dinner.
Come, Lucas, I'll show you the moat. Did you ever see a rat as big as a dachshund?
No, sir.
Gomez! What's going on?
Nothing. We were just talking.
That wasn't talking, that was conspiring.
No, it was talking. Conspiring is the weather.
That's what you were doing.
Carita, stop this foolishness.
You're keeping something from me.
Carita, I have never kept anything from you. And may lightning strike me where I stand if I'm keeping anything from you now.
So it should come to this.
Here, Kara. I feel the urge to take you in my arms.
Not today.
What? But you've never turned down a trip to heaven.
Not today. I'll be in my room until you're ready to share, like a proper husband.
Morticia!
Mia! Like a bug in a jar or a frozen cable car, I'm trapped. Like a man growing gray when his wife says not today. What if she doesn't dance with me anymore? Who could conceive it? What if I and one tiny lie started civil war? What if a line's been crossed, vows of commitment lost? How is that possible? Could that be possible?
Put the ring on just for a minute.
Dinner.
What if they hate each other?
What if they don't? Be like me. Look on the bright side.
You made me so crazy.
Maybe you two should get a room. Pugsley, stop sneaking around like that. It's my house too, okay? Excuse me while I kill my brother.
Hey, I got this. Yo! It's the Pogster, the Pogmeister, living the Pog life, y'all. What's up, little man?
You trying to be cool?
Uh-huh.
Because you're not cool.
Your sister thinks I am.
Oh, she'll get over it.
Aren't you a little young to be smoking?
I'm under a lot of stress. My sister is having an identity crisis! Okay, we're gonna go now. Can I come? Sorry, Pugs. I'm with Lucas now. Bye. But wait! Wait! What if she never tortures me anymore? How would I manage? What if she never nails my tongue to the bathroom floor? What if she walks away, leaving me
from this baby.
Why?
because it takes the lid off the id, brings out the dark side.
What do you mean?
One swig of this, and Mary Poppins turns into Medea.
I don't understand your references!
Well, stop the damn texting and pick up a book once in a while. Now quit worrying about your sister and start thinking about you and what you're going to do with your life. Time, my dear, is a thief. She'll steal your soul and flee on little fairy wings. And stay out of my shit, or I'll rip your leg off and bury it in the backyard.
Another delicious meal, all thanks to my fabulous lady wife, from whom I keep nothing. This dinner keeps me in mind of my great ancestor, Hector Fernando Escondido Chimichanga. A man hated by the church, but clever with a quip. In fact, while being burned alive, he said, "Keep it pink in the middle and a little crispy around the outside." She gets it.
Thank you, dear. And now it's time to play the game.
Oh no, not the game. It's getting late.
But it's a family tradition!
Huxley, could you just go away and die?
I will if your boyfriend will!
Kata, maybe the game is a bad idea.
Thank you, Daddy.
No, it's a good idea. And if it isn't, then someone will be sleeping on the couch for a very long time.
Actually, the game is a good idea. The best of all ideas. Sorry.
What kind of game?
We call it obligación de revelar.
Ooh, Spanish. What does it mean?
Full disclosure.
Exactly. Everyone takes a sip from the sacred family chalice.
And confesses a secret they've never told anyone.
Loosely based on the Inquisition.
And you have to absolutely tell the truth.
Or what?
Or there are consequences.
I don't think I'd be very good at that game.
Sure you would be.
Oh, no.
And now Gomez will break the ice. My husband has something he would like to disclose.
But no. The host goes last.
Lurch, the sacred chalice.
This is a sacred chalice from Addams' family's past. Firm in my digitalis, health fast. Salvation resides. Feel the sweet sensation revelation provides. Full disclosure, it's a game that we play. Let your darkest secrets give you away. Face your demons and then happily say, "I'm playing full disclosure with all these crazy happy people." Full disclosure, it's a hell of a thing. Once the favorite of the late Deja King. Doesn't matter if you're right or left wing. He loved his full disclosure. Yes, well, my disclosure comes in the form of a fairy tale. Once there was a man with a beautiful wife and two beautiful children. A humble man, I say, and yet within his breast beat the heart of a loyal and steadfast husband who treasured his wife and worshipped the ground she walked on. Thank you. Thank you. Yes. Yes. Yes.
No. No. And one day, a fox appeared with a box made of rare wood and Spanish leather. "What's in the box?" asked the kindly man. And the fox replied, "Oh, baguette, baguette." It was French fox. "In this box is a tiny little secret. Nothing important, but you must never, ever, ever, oh, sorry, ever open it." So the man took the box home to his beautiful wife, and she said, "Let's open it anyway." And the man said, "Honey, we got a good thing going here. Don't push it." And they never did open the box. And they all lived happily ever after. Full disclosure.
Yes, well, we'll just have to come back to you now, won't we? All right, Wednesday's turn.
Pass.
Oh. Yes, yes, Fester. Let's hear from Fester, the cellist. Go.
I am in love.
Oh.
I suppose you're thinking, what does a fat, bold person of no specific sexuality know about love? But I too am in love. Fester loves.
Oh, Fester, who is it?
The moon.
The moon, always in love with the moon.
Yeah, like that's normal.
That's the most beautiful thing I ever heard.
Oh, I haven't told her yet. Full disclosure.
Full disclosure, just embrace her and all for grace, I'll fall in love with the moon.
He loves
her sermon with a signature tune and call it full disclosure.
All right, Wednesday's turn.
No! Me, age before beauty. The chalice.
Time have I got left? I'm 102. I got shingles and arthritis and carditis and bursitis and cystitis. And when I pass wind, it'll start the windmills on an old Dutch painting. But I've got one more round left in me. Call me cougar, but 5'll get you 10. There's a couple of 90-year-old honeys out there just waiting to chow down on a grandma's sandwich. I just peed.
We should have put you down years ago. All right, Wednesday's turn.
Not yet. Daddy, talk to her.
I've still got the fox box problem.
Wednesday, it's your turn. The chalice, please. Where's the chalice?
Yes! Now you dash of potion. My sister blows her cool. Hopefully in slow motion. She'll draw!
Hooray for fools!
drink.
Oh, remember how it used to be, Mal? How we used to look at each other and leave the restaurant in the middle of dinner and rush home and go upstairs? Yeah, and sometimes you couldn't even wait and you would just pull the car over to the side of the road.
Mom!
And oh, lighten up, Lucas. Parents do it. Live with it. Remember, Mal, when we were crazy and the future didn't exist? What happened, Mal? The guy with the Grateful Dead t-shirt, is he ever coming back? How long do I have to wait? Oh. A woman waits for marriage. A woman waits for children. She waits for her big man.
Don't you think it'd be better if Our guests couldn't leave just yet. What do you think?
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. All right then, dead people. Give me some weather.
It's a hurricane. We're never going to make it out of the parking lot.
Well, by the keys, looks like you'll be spending the night. That's what happens when you play.
Important that they all got along.
And I thought you said it didn't matter.
Yeah, but they want to kill each other. Do you want that hang over our heads?
Boy, you sound just like your father. The root doesn't fall far from the tree, does it?
What?
Just forget it.
The apple. The apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
God, you're annoying.
You know what I think? I think you don't really want to get married. I think you just said that to stick it to your mother.
Psychoanalyze me, Lucas. It is a deep, dark hole, and you do not want to go there. Come on!
What do we do for money?
Stop being so scared of everything.
Yeah. Right, like you're not scared.
I eat scared for breakfast, honey.
Yeah.
Look, let's just go back in the house and make some rational decisions.
No!
I don't want rational decisions. I want dangerous, impulsive, crazy decisions.
Yeah!
Are you coming or not?
Look, I can't just run away like this. It's too crazy. I'm sorry.
Not as sorry as you're gonna be when you wake up and you're 46 and working for your father.
Yeah!
Would you stop that?
I can be impulsive. I just need to think about it first.
Delicious anarchy. What happens now? Can this be repaired? Or do you all leave in around an hour feeling vaguely depressed? Let's find out, shall we?
Morticia, humiliated, shamed, mortified.
Cara.
I told that Beinecke woman we kept nothing from each other.
Wednesday wasn't sure about the boy, and I didn't want to worry you.
Oh, so you wouldn't dare tell me because I'm such a terrible mother.
You're a wonderful mother.
And look at the thanks I get. I gave up my dreams for the sake of this family. I wanted to travel. I wanted to see Paris. I've never seen the sewers of Paris. And now it'll never happen.
Cara.
And so that's how it ends. Alone and forgotten, in a tiny room, living on cat food and broken dreams. That's what happens to mothers. Look at yours. She came for the weekend. The weeks turned into months. It's 12 years later and she's still up there. Deceived. Deluded, smoking weed in the attic. a grandma. Well, I'm not going to end up like your mother.
My mother? I thought she was your mother. No, seriously.
You lied to me. I can't live with that.
But Kara, I feel the urge to take you in my arms.
Not today.
But Kara!
Out! My daughter's getting married. I can't believe it's true. She doesn't ask her mother before she says I do. And how about my husband, inconstant naive? This evening's getting serious. These Beinekes won't leave. But I can't let this latest troubles rob me of my bliss. For when I'm scared of true disaster, I remember this. Death is just around the corner, waiting patiently to strike. One unplanned electrocution, that's the kind of end I can comprehend. When I'm feeling uninspired, or I need a little spree, I'm reborn, knowing death is just around the corner, coming after me. Get it, coroner? Death is just around the coroner. Aren't I hilarious? Death is just around the corner, waiting high upon a hill. Someone buried in an avalanche, that's the kind of gig I could really dig. Marriage often disappoints you. Not each husband is a gem. So I'll mourn, knowing death is just around the corner, coming after them. If life's all plans, I'll muddle through some. But when death comes, I hope it's gruesome. Ha-cha! Some people die from public stoning, faulty wiring, faulty zoning, cherry pits they didn't know were there. It could be by a jungle cat,
a slippery net,
a baseball bat,
perhaps an unsuccessful love affair. It could be in a speeding train, it could be underwater, it could be too much Novocaine, or even by your daughter.
Perhaps a bad mosquito bite,
a title fight,
religious rights.
My darling, it might even be
quick.
feel so dark, I feel so dead. All is black inside my face.
Boy, they really got to you. That doesn't even rhyme.
You got a problem with that?
Look, I did not raise my son to be kidnapped by some left-wing Spanish weirdo.
You didn't raise him, Mal. I did. You were at the office, remember?
I was at the office for you, for him. I had plans for that boy.
Oh, Mal, he's in love. Let him follow his heart.
Follow his heart? That's crazy.
What's wrong with crazy? Crazy is underrated.
Let me get this straight. Your son, your only son, wants to marry some girl who's named after the day of the week and walks around Central Park with a crossbow, and you are okay with that?
If it makes him happy, yes.
You're gonna have to come to your senses, or I am gonna have to take steps.
Good idea. Why don't you start by taking steps outside?
What?
You heard me. You wanna act like a tool? Go sleep in the shed.
Fine.
What? Nothing.
Storm's passed. I think I'll get a little moon, if you know what I mean. Ladies! Hello! Oh! Hello, ladies! Don't you look lovely in those outfits? My dear, distance is our friend. Closeness? No, thank you. A quarter of a million miles? That's a good distance for love. We never fight. Each pain is a heartbreaking separation. Each meeting, a happy reunion. When the daylight ends and the moon ascends, I would rather be just the moon and me. When I feel purple, then my heart is full. And the night is softly, sweetly calling, faster look and see. La 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 la. It's a dream that's coming true when the moon says I love you. She accepts, she attends, she believes, she befriends. La 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 la. It's a dream that's coming true.
Where do you think you're going, young lady?
Away.
Elopement?
Daddy, would you please just
no,
let me
No, this
go-
is what comes from keeping secrets. If the two of you wanted to get married, you should
there
have just
There isn't
gone
going to be any marriage.
What? Why?
He bailed.
What? A breach of promise? An outrage?
He said running away was a bad idea.
On the other hand, he does have a point.
I hate him!
Well, it's a beginning. Something to build on.
First he says he can't live without me, and then he lets me go. I love him. Why doesn't he love me?
You just said you hated him, so... Which is it?
Both.
Ah, now you got it. Right and wrong, who's to say which we should refuse? All we know, love survives either way we choose. Here you are at the edge, go ahead and fall. Don't resist, I insist, love still conquers all. It even conquered you, my adorable little Attila. You had to go and grow up, didn't you?
And you're cool with that?
Yes. And no. I'm feeling happy. I'm feeling sad. A little childish. A little dad. I think of all the days you've known. Feeling happy and sad again. I think I'm rested, but then I'm tired. Today requested, tomorrow fired. And then a boy says he adores she who once was yours. How can I ignore such sad and happy, why should I choose? Life is full of contradictions. Every inch of mine. At the moment we start weeping, that's when we should smile. So many memories. Wednesday. Eating her first worm. Wednesday. Sealing up her baby brother in the wall. Wednesday. Setting fire to the Jehovah's Witness. And I think, where have all the years gone? And I'm sad. But then, I see this lovely young woman. And I'm happy. Happy sad. Happy sad. It's like the bull when the matador put the sword into him and he look at the matador and say, nice job. I hate you. In every heaven, you'll find some hell. A welcome in each farewell. Life can be harsh, the future strict. Who would dare predict? And the boy you've picked, not bad. So let's be happy, forever happy. Thank you.
long have you been standing in the shadows?
My whole life.
Nice! You should have been a writer. Have you met my daughter? This is Wednesday. The best thing that will ever happen to you. Don't screw it up.
Yes?
Look, I can't stand the idea of not being with you.
5 minutes ago you could.
Yeah, but see, the lover always comes back. Ulysses, Tristan, Romeo.
Look, I'm homeschooled. What's your point?
I'd rather die than live without you.
Okay, prove it.
What?
Prove it, here.
Where did you get it?
Put that apple on your head and go stand against that tree.
Wait, you're gonna...
Uh-huh.
You're crazy.
And you're not crazy enough. That's the problem. Once I was hopeful, thought we were one. Life less than perfect, finally begun. No, you know why? Because I will guide the arrow, and I'll guide it with my love. How does that work exactly?
We're connected, see? We're destined to be together, so nothing bad can happen.
Yeah, but what if I miss?
Then you'll be the last thing I ever see.
That is so hot.
Now will you marry me?
Oh yes, Louis, 1,000 times yes!
Lucas! Lucas!
Gotcha!
Did you hear that? That boy is willing to die for love! It's hard to believe that he's your son!
They were so happy!
Remember that? Feeling happy?
What happened?
You turned into an unfeeling, selfish, rigid control freak.
Fester, you're a wise person. How can I fix this? What can I do?
Don't worry. It'll come to you.
It wasn't always like this. I was happy-go-lucky once. Used to go to parties with play the guitar and sleep until noon. Then you get a wife and kids and a mortgage.
Keep going.
What do I say?
Remember how you felt the first time you saw her.
Go. Alice, it's Mal.
I know.
No, the old Mal.
The old Mal with the guitar and the t-shirt.
And the headband.
Headband? Oh my God, the headband. Oh, you were pretty crazy back then, you know that?
Yeah, I know. I guess I got lost, Alice. More than most men. But honey, I swear, I'll be crazy again.
Mal, you're rhyming.
Just for you, baby. Just for you. I learned from Lucas. I learned from you. I wasn't happy. I wasn't true. But then the way you spoke at dinner touched my soul. Completely crazy, yet completely in control. So when you kicked me out, I said, let's rock and roll. So I'll be crazier than you, far crazier than you. It warms me up to see you living lost. When I'm crazier than you, just crazier than you, I'll drop the plan, you'll be the man in charge.
All this time and all I needed was the hook that you submit.
Too afraid and too conceited to believe that you were it. But the journey's now completed.
Someplace else.
Mommy, I have a full disclosure.
Yes?
What if you tried to do something to somebody, but you ended up doing it to somebody else, by mistake?
Are we talking about anyone we know?
Well, I was talking to Grandma before, and she told
me— Don't listen to that ancient woman. She may not even be part of this family.
Is Wednesday really gonna marry that guy?
She might.
Oh no! Make me feel better, Mommy!
Okay. Life is a tightrope, my child. And at the other end is your coffin. Better?
Uh-huh. Thanks, Mommy.
Now, close your eyes. Or the monster won't come out and eat you all up. Pugsley. Pugsley. Sleep well, my little vermin. Your mommy's life is falling apart, and she needs to go away for a while. And years from now, when your marriage collapses and you want to know who put us all on the road to hell, you can thank your father. Take care of my baby, will you? Keep him in harm's way.
Morticia, 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 Morticia. One little secret and she throws me out. What was I supposed to do? I was trapped. But my darling, my only one, I make it up to you. You want to see the world? Done. You want sewers? I'll show you sewers fit for a queen. Where's that hotel guy? Here we go. Let's see. Let's see. Hotel Med, Rue de Toilette. Condemned 6 times by the Board of Health. Not enough. Not enough. Voila! Hotel Nosferatu. Rating -3 stars. No towels, no windows, oh, no staff. Bingo! The worst hotel in Paris. Get them on the line. This could be the final round, my friend. Hurry! Did I ever once expect the worst? Did I ever dream that I could feel this way? Dios mío, no, this is the first. I'm a Latin man and Latin men are smart. Everything we do is muy sincere. Leading with a sword as much as with a heart. Never once was I prepared to hear. She poisoned me. No one else had cared enough to try. How did she uncover all the joys in me? All the way she promised I would die. Every year that passes, I adore her more. Anyone who knows us would agree. She's my every fever, flu, and canker sore. She's my only hepatitis B. My marriage is at stake. Can you confirm this is the worst hotel in Paris? Because I need to get your ghoulish guarantee. What will I pay if you will say you'll serve my petit déjeuner from an abandoned and condemned patisserie? Now let's be clear, don't want to circulate misnomers. There must be roaches in the back at any cost. It says right here in my new guide I bought from Fromers that even in July the pipes are thick with frost.
Gomez! Gomez! Morticia's leaving!
What?
She's at the front gate with a ballet! It's the end of the family!
Is this the moment where I turn a little gray? Is this the moment where my marriage vows decay? Is this the moment where Morticia runs away? No! Not today! Not today! Not today! There's another secret I haven't told you.
What?
That you are the most magnificent, most desirable,
most delectable of all women.
That's no secret.
No, but even you had a secret once.
Never.
And if you are wrong?
I never am.
But if you were, what would you give me?
Name it.
Addams.
Go on.
Many years ago, when you loved me and you wanted to marry me, we went to your father and told him, and he said, wonderful, let's go tell your mother. And what did you say?
How could I possibly...
You said no! No, she'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and ruin the whole thing.
Well, that's different. My mother was condescending, judgmental, and withholding, and loved nothing more than stirring up trouble.
Uh-huh.
Oh, God. I've turned into my mother.
And Wednesday is you. Isn't it wonderful?
You did that like a lawyer.
No, just a husband and a father. Not so easy, in fact, very difficult. Let's live before we die. Let's laugh before we cry. Let's hold each other tight and dance. If I have caused you pain, it's easy to explain. Come fill me with delight and dance. My love, my wife, forever we will be. But Wednesday's life, that too is part of me. Two women I adore and swore to suffer for. Let's end this tug of war and dance.
Mother told me to beware of clever men with silver tongues.
Ah, what I lack in depth, I make up for in shallowness.
You really think you can sway me with a joke?
Yeah, it's the last thing I try before the chloroform. Yeah.
Tomorrow I may be in rainy air, Paris.
Please stay right where you are and dance. You're more than that by far, so dance.
The place
we're in can never be what was. To weep and give in, to do what dancing does. My darling, I was bad, bad husband and bad dad. Instead of being sad,
alone
we're lost, we're drifting out to sea. But side by side, we're gloomy as can be. Morticia, I was wrong. I knew it all along. Forgive me with a song.
And dance.
Mil amor, creature of constant surprises. You have legs!
Ladies.
Thank you.
tell your friends. Word of mouth is so important. Young lady, step forward and speak the words every mother longs to hear.
I'm sorry. Do you really want to marry this boy?
I do.
Why?
He's willing to die for me. Mother, can I ask you something?
Yes. Go ahead. Just ask her.
Can we have your blessing?
Of course. May you have many children, and may they give you as much grief as you've given us.
Attention, everybody! I have a full disclosure of my own. I am taking my beautiful wife to Paris! You go to Paris, you go to Paris, you go to Paris!
Gomez, the sewers!
Special package, one day, seven nights.
Oh, je t'aime, mon cher. Je t'aime toujours.
Ah, the French!
Okay, unseekers! My acrimonium went missing, so I went sniffing around. Tell them what you did, you little bedbug.
You're all so smart, you figure it out.
All right, let's see. You were afraid you would lose your sister.
So you stole my acrimonium.
To make Wednesday and Lucas fall out of love with each other.
But I never got to drink it because...
I pass it to my mother.
And I drank it and became who I really am.
Which made me fall in love with my family all over again.
And I reached deep into my reservoir of womanly compassion and bathed your father in forgiveness.
Welcome to the family! Oh, we're not losing a daughter. We're gaining three. Beinekies. Ooh, they're so cute. Young man, for purely selfish motives, you turned a perfectly simple dinner party into a night from hell.
We couldn't be more proud.
Huxley, you're an artist. You rearranged life itself and it all came out even. You're the best brother in the world.
Ah! So you're still gonna torture me?
Of course, until you get a girl of your own.
My son, you embrace the darkness of your despair, and suddenly the world makes sense. You are a true Addams.
Something old.
Something new.
charm.